Wow. Well, thank you very much for that kind introduction. I want to thank the GRIO Awards Committee and my fellow honorees. I also want to thank my wife, Katrina, for supporting my dreams and being with me every step of the way for 32 years. For being an amazing mother to our children and being my partner in life. A very special thank you to my friend and mentor, Byron Allen, for his vision to create the GRIO Awards to showcase the vast talent within the Black community. And for his unrelenting drive to change America for us all. My friends, we are fortunate to live in a country where we can dream. I'm a dreamer. And as a young boy, my parents encouraged me to dream, and my mother encouraged me to dream big. If I represent anything, it is the great possibilities of the promise of America. America, while imperfect, is a country where you can have big dreams, a place where, with hard work and a bit of luck, you can make those big dreams come true. It may not be easy, especially if you are Black. But when you set your mind to do something and you are committed to success and unwilling to fail, you will achieve great success. And we must remember to tell our kids the only limitations that there are those that we allow others to impose upon us or that we impose upon ourselves. Thank you. It is with great humility that I accept this award. To be recognized as a leader in this room full of powerful champions and barrier breakers is something that I do not take lightly because it comes with great responsibility. We are living in challenging times. Despite the global reckoning that was sparked by the murder and the videotape of that murder of George Floyd, there has been little advancement of the democratic process in terms of social equity and economic inclusion and empowerment for African Americans. Now let's remember, America is a capitalistic democracy. And the pillars of our democracy rest upon capitalism. If capitalism is inequitable, our democracy cannot endure. Think about that. The pillars of our democracy rest upon capitalism. And if it's unfair, then our nation cannot endure. We know that the pathway to wealth runs through entrepreneurship, and the fuel to run the motors of business is capital. Now let me give you an illuminating fact. Today, there is over $82 trillion invested in venture capital and private equity. Of that $82 trillion, less than 1.3% of it is invested in firms run and owned by women and people of color combined. What that means is 98.7% of all venture capital money, $81 trillion out of $82 trillion, is provided to white men. Yet white men represent only 31% of America's population. Women represent 51% of America. We, Black Americans, are 13% of America. Thus, you have 54% of the population receiving less than 1.3% of the investment capital. This one statistic illuminates what I refer to as economic apartheid. We can no longer accept this economic oppression. Now, economic injustice doesn't just surface at various times. It's constant. It's continual. And it's a knee on the neck of every Black American each and every day. And it is the greatest obstacle in our quest for equality. I've made economic inclusion and economic empowerment for Black Americans my mission for the rest of my life. And you may ask me why, but it's because I love my people. And I love my people, and I love America. In order to save our democracy, we must make it fair. So I ask all of you to join me in speaking out about economic exclusion of our people. Now, Dave Chappelle has done that, and I've watched him do it. And he has used his art to do that. Many of you have spoken out on that. But if we all do it together, we can change America and make America a more perfect nation. I'll leave you with a quote from my friend, former President Barack Obama. Change will not come if we wait for some other person or some other time. We are the ones we've been waiting for. We are the change we seek. Thank you very much for this incredible honor. Good night.